I'm attorney Pat Dunn. Auto accidents are a part of life. I hope you never need an attorney, but if you do, the team at the Mack Law Firm is here to help.
We're back in Independence with Dr. Alecia Cyprian at Southeast Community Health, and this is one of several locations. In fact, you're getting ready to move from here over to a much larger facility in Independence.
Good morning, Ken. Absolutely. We're getting ready to move actually to East Railroad Avenue, where the Dollar General used to sit. So we anticipate opening within the next 6 weeks to a much larger facility of about 10,000 square feet.
So many things happening in your far-flung operation. I hardly know where to begin, but let's start with the big grant you got through Congressman Garrett Graves for St. Helena.
Yes, through the Payroll Protection Program, as we received a $262,000 grant to expand COVID testing in the communities that we serve. And that includes Tangipahoa, East Baton Rouge, Livingston, as well as St. Helena Parish. And we also are working with Dr. Gina Lagarde, the medical director for Region 9 from the Louisiana Department of Health, to target hotspots to bring our mobile medical unit to those to do testing in areas that have not received any COVID-19 testing.
How much COVID-19 testing are you doing?
We're doing testing with symptomatic patients. We ask that patients call our health center to schedule appointments, because we do temperature checks for any patient that enters our facilities. So they simply call us, and those who are exhibiting symptoms, we schedule testing for them. To date, we've done between 50 and 100 testing kits across our clinics.
Well, people can run a fever for a lot of different reasons. What about a person that just has some other illness and they need treatment?
If they do so, Ken, we highly recommend, as the governor said, safer at home, especially even in as we have entered phase one. We recommend that they contact us, because we now offer telehealth. So we offer telehealth for primary care medical visits. We offer telehealth for behavioral health care, and also teledentistry for some dental services.
You know, looking at the Louisiana statistics, it's very striking how African Americans have borne the brunt of this illness far beyond their proportion of the population. Obviously, you're Black and you're a medical professional. Do you have a theory on why this is so? Because the numbers, I mean, they're wildly disproportionate toward the Black community.
Absolutely, Ken. And not only in Louisiana, the numbers for African Americans testing positive and unfortunately transitioning due to COVID-19 are greater in Louisiana. Underlying health conditions, but really health equity and having access to health care, depending on whether you live in a rural or an urban area, and social determinants of health are also impacting health outcomes for African Americans. So I am hopeful that the governor's health equity committee and access to health care services at the national and state level will help to improve health outcomes for the African American and Latino population as well, who is also suffering at disproportionate numbers.
You know, standing here in Independence, looking at that great mobile unit that you have, it just reminds me that some of this is just the reality that if you live in a rural area, you have a lot of benefits. Boy, you get closer to nature and so forth. But the disadvantage is you're just farther away from stuff like clinics.
Absolutely, which is why Southeast purchased the medical mobile unit, so that we can bring the care to the communities that we serve. So we are working with the Tangipahoa Parish government. We are working, again, with the Louisiana Department of Health, specifically with Region 9, to assist them in bringing the testing to the communities where it's needed the most.
One thing I love about your operation is that you tell people, if you have nothing, if you have Medicare, if you have Medicaid, if you have private insurance, if you have cash, whatever you got, we'll take it.
Thank you so much for sharing that, and you're absolutely right. We are funded to provide healthcare services to individuals regardless of their ability to pay. So those who are uninsured or underinsured will be able to receive healthcare services from one of our locations within Southeast Community Health Systems' network of clinics.
So, I mean, you have to be very creative with the financing or with the ability of people to pay, because maybe they'll have a couple of things that add up.
Absolutely. And we also do a lot of partnerships on grants with other organizations to help us to have the revenue to be able to provide that care. But regardless of ability to pay, we will provide medical services to the communities we serve.
So what are you doing differently because of COVID-19, other than obviously you're doing a lot of testing?
We are. And telehealth has become a big modality for services throughout healthcare across the country. So we have employed telehealth, and currently over 50% of the visits that are done at Southeast Community Health Systems are done via telehealth.
So how does that work?
You're able to, as long as you have a telephone or a laptop or technology, or for behavioral health, we are also able to do audio calls. You simply will download an app that we will have one of our healthcare team members communicate with you in downloading that app, and you actually, at the time of your visit, you select that app and you're able to see our provider, and our provider is able to see you to provide care to you.
What are you seeing in our area? And you serve the Florida parishes, Zachary, Baton Rouge, St. Helena, Kentwood here in Independence, Hammond and Albany, so forth. As far as COVID-19 in this region, what do you find?
Well, I can only speak with respect to what we're seeing at Southeast Community Health Systems. As I shared earlier, our testing numbers that we've had with respect to COVID-19 is about 50. So we're seeing patients who really are having medical issues other than COVID-19 for our clinics. Just like any other sector of business, individuals also, we've seen phone call volumes decrease. The first few weeks after the governor's proclamation, we also saw a 50% decline in visits to our health center. So we want the community to know that we are following CDC guidelines. We are using high disinfection cleaning in our clinics and are ready to provide provision of care to our communities.
Well, we know New Orleans has been a hot spot, Baton Rouge somewhat, not as much, but for the rural area that we're in, do you get a feel for how serious this pandemic is and how it might be different in a more rural setting?
Ken, in a more rural setting, as I've shared earlier during this interview, it's really the fact that there are social determinants of health and access barriers to care, and one of those is transportation. So those pockets of rural areas in Tangipahoa, St. Helena Parish have really not received much, if none, no testing at all, which is why I am working with the Louisiana Department of Health and identifying hot spots in areas where testing needs to be done.
What else do you want to share with us?
Thank you for the opportunity to let our communities know that Southeast Community Health Systems is available for primary care, for behavioral health care, as well as for dental services.
You know, our friends at Tangipahoa Economic Development would never forgive me if I didn't bring up the fact that you're a major employer and you partner with businesses, you partner with governmental agencies. So I hate to put everything down to money, but on the other hand, from a dollars and cents perspective, you are a major operation.
We understand that we are an economic driver in Tangipahoa and surrounding parishes, and we want to continue to be an economic driver and continue to provide quality, affordable health care in the communities that we serve.
How many employees do you have?
We have over 110.
I mean, if there was a plant that came in with 110 employees, the governor might show up to cut the ribbon.
Absolutely, and we welcome the governor to come to Tangipahoa Parish and assist when we do the grand opening at 336 East Railroad Avenue.
It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangilawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.